Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. In this video, we'll examine how VTP can be used with MSTP. VTP's primary function is to synchronize switches VLAN databases, but it can also be used to synchronize MSTP configurations. Here's what we'll cover. We'll see how to enable the MSTP feature for VTP, and then how to use VTP to sync MSTP configurations. This should be a fairly short video, just looking at a few new commands you need. Let's summarize the main points before we get started. By default, the VTP mode and VTP primary commands only apply to the VLANs feature. So VTP has two main features, the VLAN feature and the MSTP feature. By default, when you configure VTP, it only enables the VLANs feature. So switches will sync their VLAN databases, but not their MSTP configurations. But when the MSTP feature is activated, switches will synchronize their MSTP configurations to the VTP primary server. Specifically, they sync their region name, revision number, and VLAN mappings. Let's get started. For this video, we'll use the same topology as in the MST regions video. But instead of manually configuring each switch, we'll use VTP to sync the configurations in each region. VTP version 3 enables switches in the same VTP domain to sync the configurations that make up the MCID, the MST configuration ID. Those are the name, revision number, and the MSTI VLAN mappings. Keep in mind this is only possible in VTP v3. It won't work in version 1 or version 2. In the above network, there should be two VTP domains, one for each MST region. Region 123 uses VLANs 1 to 100, and region 456 uses VLANs 1 to 50 and 101 to 150. They require different VLANs and different MSTP configurations, so they should be separate VTP domains. It's worth noting that each switch's priority must be manually configured. VTP can't be used to configure each switch's priority for each MST instance. We've already covered how to configure MST priority, so I won't show the commands here. You can check the diagram to confirm each switch's priority. But to reduce the clutter a bit, I'll just leave the MSTI0 priorities. We won't be focusing on the priorities in this video anyway. So as you know by now, a switch with the default VTP settings will automatically join a VTP v1 or v2 domain upon receiving an advertisement. And if the domain is using version 2, the switch will also use version 2. But this is not the case for version 3. To ensure that each switch is in the proper domain and uses VTP v3, you must manually configure each switch's VTP domain name and version. For example, here are the commands on switch 1 and switch 4. You should configure them on the other switches too. Note that I gave the VTP domains the same names as the MST regions, but they don't have to be the same. Just make sure the switches in each MST region have matching VTP domain names. Now that each switch is in the appropriate VTP region and is running VTP v3, let's examine the current state of VTP before doing any further configurations. Here is Show VTP Status on switch 1. In the top section, you can see that VTP version 3 is running, and it's in the domain region 123. By default, it's a VTP server for the VLAN feature, as shown in the top line of this section. But you know that already. However, for the MST feature, it is in transparent mode by default, so we have to activate it. And at the bottom of the output, there is Feature Unknown. This is an interesting part of VTP. VTP v3 can be used to sync other database types, not just the VLAN database and MSTP configurations. Now, these switches only support the VLAN and MST features. And honestly, I'm not sure if anyone has implemented other features with VTP. But the option is here. And this setting controls how a switch reacts to VTP messages for features the switch doesn't support. VTP mode transparent unknown, which is the default setting, means the switch will forward messages for unknown features. And VTP mode off unknown means it will drop the messages. You can issue the VTP mode server unknown and VTP mode client unknown commands, but the commands will be rejected. Only transparent and off modes are supported. Anyway, that's not the topic of this video, so let's move on. Just for a demonstration, I used VTP mode client on switch 1. Notice it says setting device to VTP client mode for VLANs. And then when I make it a server again, it's the same. When I make it the VTP primary server, a similar message is shown. This system is becoming primary server for feature VLAN. And this log message says the same. So the VTP mode and VTP primary commands only apply to the VLAN feature by default. To make the switch a VTP server or client for the MST feature, you have to specify that in the command. I used VTP mode server MST on switch 1, and now it's a VTP server for the MST feature. And then the same for the VTP primary command. Add the MST keyword to the end of the command. And now it's the primary server for the MST VTP feature. Like for VLANs, with VTP v3 enabled, only the primary server can make configuration changes for MSTP. Note that this can be the same switch as the primary server for the VLAN feature, or it can be a different switch. I made switch 1 the primary server for both, but you don't have to. So here's the output of show VTP status again, focusing only on the MST section. Notice the configuration revision number. Both VTP and MSTP use a revision number, but the configuration revision for the MST feature is separate from the configuration revision in the MCID. The VTP revision number automatically increments every time you make a change to the MSTP configuration. But the MSTP revision number doesn't automatically increment. The two numbers are independent. Now let's configure VLANs and MSTP on switch 1. First, I created VLANs 1 to 100, and then here are the MSTP configurations. Nothing new here. Setting the name, revision number, and VLAN mappings. And here is the output of show VTP status for VLANs. Switch 1 now has 104 VLANs, and its revision number is 2. And here's the output for MST. Again, the revision number is 2, the same as above. Note that these revision numbers are separate and will increment independently. They are the same now, but that's just a coincidence. So here are switch 1's MSTP configurations. Region 1, 2, 3, revision 1, VLANs 1 to 50 mapped to instance 1, and VLANs 51 to 100 mapped to instance 2. Now let's check on switch 2 to see if it has synced its configurations. As the output here shows, it has added VLANs 2 to 100 to its VLAN database, so it's synced with switch 1. And what about its MSTP configurations? Well, it hasn't synced those. It still has all VLANs mapped to instance 0. Why is that? The output of show VTP status shows why. It's still in transparent mode for the MST feature. So it will forward advertisements, but won't sync its configurations. To fix that, I configured server mode for MST with the command VTP mode server MST. And now you can see it has synced its configurations with switch 1. And show VTP status shows that it's a VTP server now for the MST feature. Now to demonstrate something, I entered MST config mode and tried to change the MST revision to 2. But when I exit, this message is shown. MST region is not configurable, as the system is not the primary server for MST database. So as I mentioned before, only the primary server, switch 1, can modify the configurations. And this applies to both VLANs and MST configurations. Okay, so we saw switch 1's and switch 2's configurations. On switch 3, you just need to do the same as on switch 2. Use VTP mode server MST to make it a VTP server for the MST feature. Then it will sync its configurations. Now the configurations for switches 4, 5, and 6 in region 4, 5, 6 are basically identical, so I'll just briefly review them here. I'll make switch 4 the VTP primary server for VLANs and MSTP, so it requires the most configurations. First, use the VTP primary command to make it the primary server for VLANs. Then make it a VTP server for MST, and also the primary server for MST. Then create the necessary VLANs, 1 to 50 and 101 to 150 in this case. And then the MST configurations. Name region 456, revision 1, VLANs 1 to 50 to instance 1, and VLANs 101 to 150 to instance 2. Now as for switch 5 and switch 6, We just need to make them VTP servers for MST. So on both of them, configure VTP mode server MST. Okay, now we have two synchronized VTP domains and MST regions. I verified on switch 6, and you can see it has synced its MST configurations. And that's it. We have configured both regions. For review, first make sure to configure each switch's VTP domain name and VTP version 3, and then use these commands shown here to make the switches sync their VLAN databases and MSTP configurations. Okay, in this video, we covered how to enable the MSTP feature for VTP, and verified that switches synced their MSTP configurations. Let's review some of the main points. The first is that, by default, the VTP mode and VTP primary commands only apply to the VLANs feature. They don't enable the MSTP feature for VTP. This means that switches will sync their VLAN databases, but not their MSTP configurations. When the MSTP feature is activated, switches will sync their MSTP configurations to the VTP primary server. To do that, use VTP mode, followed by the mode, and then the MST keyword. This only works in VTP v3. Versions 1 and 2 can't sync MST settings. And don't forget to use VTP primary MST to configure the primary server for the MST feature. Finally, note that each switch's MSTI priority values must be manually configured. VTP can only sync the region name, revision number, and the VLAN mappings. Okay, now let's move on to a quiz to test your understanding. This was a fairly simple lesson, so we'll just do one question. Here it is. In a network using VTP v3, which of the following statements are true about the synchronization of MSTP configurations? Select 2. Pause the video now to think about the answers. Okay, the first correct answer is C. VTP v3 requires manual configuration of the switch's VTP domain and mode to ensure MSTP configurations are synchronized. First, you need to ensure the switch is in the same VTP domain as its neighbors. And you also need to manually configure the VTP mode for the MST feature. For example, with VTP mode server MST. Otherwise, the switch won't sync its MSTP configurations. And the second correct answer is E. VTP can sync the MST region name, configuration revision, and VLAN mappings. However, it can't sync all MST-related configurations, such as a switch's priority. And that's why F is incorrect. A is incorrect because VTP versions 1 and 2 can't sync MSTP configurations. Only version 3 can. B is incorrect because you can configure different switches to be the primary server for VLANs and MSTP. They don't have to be the same switch. And D is incorrect because the primary server for VLANs won't automatically become the primary server for MSTP. You must manually configure it. Okay, that's all for the quiz and this video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members who support me through YouTube channel membership. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, George, Nasir Chowdhury, Gustavo Macedo, Marcel Lord, Drago Cirnea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Vitaus194, Mark Jackson, Bold1C1U, Gerald Guillaume, Fristos1207, Hector Hernandez, Arpad Conives, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yavuz, Samuel Tavares, Kevin Hayes, Roger Bratseth, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemejev, Cats for Life, Adelson Pereira, Farad69, Madmark50484, Alexandru Stratan, Hiago Bicalho, DMJ2, Lucian Stoichitoyu, Kurt Nell, Dear Diso, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Pedro Hartman, Tricky Mickey 123456, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Toxic, Wilmer Romero, Sinan Sarisinar, Gio, Daniel Andrade, Mike Crumby, Dragos George, Jairo Francisco, Philip Jovanovich, Mateusz Wzaszynski, Ruben Hernandez, Electro Jedi, Trevor Goldman, Gavin Paul Tech, Sunny Idigu, Jeffrey C., Chitsinde, Stephen White, Edificare, Fio Fio Hein, Dimitro Lis, Faris Al-Zaharani, Jean-Marcel Belmont, Michal Chapsky, Hemanth Jabalpuri, Dariush D, Juan Morales, Gonzalo Nicolas, Doomed Soul, Christine Schubert, Julio Maya, Josie Egresso, Komlan Kapedemi, Hashem Rodef, Anand Abiankar, Clyde Mkorobindo, Okello, Adekola Ismail Salami, Orlando Flores, Ray Enriquez, Adrian Martinez, MD Danielwitz, Avinash KR, Sonu Nayar, GG7, Rohan Surti, Tobe Hedin, Arturo Ray Mejia, Vic, and MDS Electronar Zedja. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching. Thank you.